To the supply chain crisis and how it's affecting your Christmas list, shortages of popular toys leading some parents to turn to unconventional shopping methods. ABC's Deirdre Bolton is here with more. Deirdre, good morning.
Good morning. When experts say that tech-savvy people are creating automated computer programs or bots to purchase popular toys and other products online with the intent of selling them at a much higher price for the holiday season.
It's one of the busiest shopping seasons of the year, and the clock is ticking to get some of those must-have gifts.
Parents go to any lengths to get their kids what they want for Christmas.
With the supply chain crunched and ships sitting off our coasts, some products are scarce, leading to more bot activity than ever.
These bots are so much faster than you and I are. And so if you've had this experience, if you're after something that's very popular and you've seen it in stock, you may have tried, you've gotten it into your cart, and then suddenly it's snatched away from you at the last minute. That is all these bots working.
And the price gouge on these resale products, not in the Christmas spirit. One collector sees the pricing pressure firsthand when looking for a special Pokemon anniversary item.
Retails for $120, and you'll see it on eBay for over $300, even $600 even. So it's insane.
The bots are fast, but you can use social media to stay one click ahead.
The reason why you have to use social media is because the key to buying these consoles is to knowing when the retailers restock.
You need to be early in the digital line to be ready. Experts say turn on push notifications for social media accounts that announce new item availability and releases. Another tip, join rewards or insider programs at a well-known retailer. They will fill your order as soon as possible.
Retailers are working very hard to give human beings their level shot.
The resale practices used by bots aren't illegal, but experts say buyer beware if thinking of purchasing with one.
If you buy a PlayStation through a bot, what happens if it breaks? You know, what are your return rights? How do you file a warranty claim? Think about those things as well.
Mike also told me if you're still going to go ahead anyway and buy with a bot, protect yourself as much as possible. So ask your credit card company to issue a one-time credit card number. Use a one-time password, not one that you use anywhere else for the transaction. Just separate yourself from your identity as much as possible. Back to you guys. Wow.
This is where we are now. Bots for gift buying.
It's that okay. Serious and intense for kids, is it, you guys? Again, yep, you yep. know, with having kids yourself.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.